Hello, I'm Garrett Dawe. I'm the ITS coordinator for MDOT's North Region. And today we're in Waters, Michigan, in Otsego County along I-75. And we're here to talk about the RWIS system that's new to MDOT's North Region as well as the Superior Region. And right behind me here is what we call an environmental sensor station. And it's a collection of these that make up the road weather information system, what we refer to as RWIS. And as you can see on the tower, there's several atmospheric sensors, starting with the air temperature sensor, which is the cylindrical sensor on the bottom of the tower there. And then moving up, we have a present weather and visibility sensor, as well as an illumination light for maintenance purposes. And then near the top of the tower, there's a camera that has 8 pre-programmed positions. It takes still pictures about every 10 minutes to verify what you're seeing, you know, as far as data. What we're looking at here is called an anemometer, and it measures wind speed. And then at the very top is a cellular antenna. And all the data that's collected by these sensors is stored in what's called an RPU on the tower itself. And then that information is sent to some servers through a private company via that cellular antenna. Also, that goes along with these environmental sensor stations is a pavement sensor and subsurface probe, which are located out in the roadway, which we can talk about next. As you can see now, I'm approaching a handhole, which contains wiring that runs back to the tower and to the remote processing unit from these in-pavement sensors. And this is really what our maintenance staff really likes to look at when they're utilizing the RWIS system. The sensor on the left out here is called an impavement sensor. And it detects the condition of the roadway. It can tell you if it's dry, if it's wet, if there's snow on the road, if the potential for ice forming on the road is there, or if there actually is ice on the road. So that tells our maintenance staff if they need to come out and plow, if they need to come out and put salt or chemical down. And then also in that pavement sensor is it can detect the percent of chemical on the roadways, which also tells our maintenance staff if the amount of chemical out there now is sufficient or if more needs to go down. And then on the right is what we call a subsurface probe. That has a bunch of sensors that go down below the pavement about 6 feet. And they're all temperature sensors, and so they detect how deep the frost is underneath the roadway or if there's frost at all. And that helps with our when we're putting weight restrictions on during the spring. And I can tell our maintenance staff when those need to go on and then ultimately when they can come off. Well, we're here at the offices of the Otsego County Road Commission with Greg Teckel, one of their foremen, and he's going to show us the RWIS system online and how it benefits his job.
What we have here is just a laptop, and you log in and you can go to Northern Lower is what I do. What we have is, for instance, here the Waters site, which we were at, is showing dry. If you click on to the camera, there's 8 different pictures of the I-75. That's 20 minutes away, having to drive down in that area and check where you can literally click on to this website and you're there. And that's from the water site where we were at. If you click on one of those, it's a larger, more detailed picture of it, and you can see road conditions. It shows the date and the time, and it helps tremendously in determining, you know, whether or not you need to put salt on the roads or plow or what. Way back when, we literally had to, you know, go out in a pickup truck and check or look at the bank temperature. This has helped tremendously in making the job easier and more efficient.
Well, currently MDOT has 25 environmental sensor stations installed statewide. 13 of them are in the Upper Peninsula and 12 are in the Northern Lower Peninsula. And the ultimate goal is to have many more than that installed statewide. And in the Northern Lower Peninsula alone, there will be 50 within 6 to 7 years. And the ultimate goal is to not only have them benefit our maintaining agencies and their response times, but also to have those stations work together to help forecast major weather events. And that will even better benefit the motoring public.